Solvente Omnes. Today we're going to be talking about Roman clothing. Roman clothing is a huge topic. I'm just going to be talking about some of the various togas and kind of a general overview. There are resources out there if you want to go into more depth about Roman clothing. This is not the end-all lecture about Roman clothing. It's going to be a kind of a quick overview. Just remember, with Roman clothing, clothing and what people wear convey status. So you can tell, if you look at these people up here, you can tell their status. A Roman citizen wearing a typical toga here with a tunic underneath. You have a Roman matron. The hairstyle says late first century. You have here a senator with the stripes along here. You have a priest. You have the skirt and the breastplate of a soldier or general. You have people who are going out in just their tunics. They could be a Roman citizen working in the fields, but probably more likely these are slaves. So you can tell a lot by their status, and just like how we wear certain clothing can convey our status as well. All right, so here it goes, the basics about Roman clothing. Now, a toga was the basic dress of a Roman citizen. And it's a typical, when you take a look at a toga, it is folded a traditional way. And this is a toga of the first century or so, BC, and you can tell it's a toga because of these folds. And there's two major folds, the sinus, which is this kind of looping fold down low that comes up over, and then the umbo, which is kind of like a little pouch thing here in the front. You could also, some people say, that you could also store things in the umbo. Now, other things to watch about this is often, of course, they wear a tunic underneath, which is this kind of like a long shirt. And these togas would take at least enough help. Well, you need help from another person to put this on. And the actual piece of cloth, and during some time periods, were as long as like 20 feet plus. So these are long pieces of cloth. They're heavy. It takes a lot. They have to prepare. They have to be made specially for this, and they show that this person is a Roman citizen. The toga is kind of like your formal wear. If you're just hanging out at home normally, you probably wouldn't be wearing your toga. You'd be wearing a tunic or something like that. But if you're going out into public, you're going to the law court, you're going to give a speech in front of the assembly, you're going to run for political office, you want to show your best, you would wear a toga. All right. Now, here's some pictures of some tunicas. Now, of course, the tunicas would be underneath. Traditionally, Romans even wear tunicas under their togas. And there was a very famous man named Cato the Younger who supposedly didn't wear anything under his toga. But later on, during the first century, they did. You have here it's a regular toga, regular. Then if you're part of the equestrian class, the upper business, wealthy business class, they'd have a single stripe on them, a thin stripe. And if you're a senator, part of the senatorial class, you would have a bigger stripe on your tunica. And here's a picture. Also, when you were a priest and you're performing a sacrifice, you would take this toga. This is a picture of Divus Augustus, and you'd put the toga over your head. But you see, it has the sinus with the umbo. It's very draped in that classical way, and it conveys that he's a Roman. He is a citizen, and then he's acting here as a priest. All right. Now, the various togas, you want to be putting this down in your composition notebook, hopefully. Various togas. These are some of the togas that were famous. There's a whole bunch of different togas. Toga virilis. It's an off-white toga. It is the toga you put on when you become of age, after you become a man. It means literally the manly toga. Toga praetexta. Often, also remember that men are the ones who traditionally wore togas. Toga praetexta is an off-white with a broad purple borders. This is what was worn by senators and also young people, or young men. Okay, so an off-white with purple borders. Toga pula is a dark-colored toga that was worn in periods of mourning if someone died in your family. Toga candida, white, worn by candidates for political office. They wear a white toga to show their purity. Often they'd be bleached. They had various ways to do that. Also, then they'd use some chalk to like put on the parts that say if there was a black spot or something like that, they could put some chalk on it to try to make it even more white. So, and we get the word, of course, candidate from this. Okay, toga picta. Purple toga worn by emperors on special occasions. Also, it's also worn by people who are triumphing. So it'd be a toga picta. And there we go. There's the togas. So if you need to stop it to put them all down, that'd be great. I keep moving here. Here's a picture of a young person. You can tell. And he's done. He has a classical orator pose. But then if you also look at the toga, the different folds on it. All right. Then we have a more elderly gentleman. Again, you can see the folds and the sinus and the umbo. Here's a picture of, very famous picture of a Roman senate. This is more modern. This is a modern painting, of course. You see, this is kind of like what we always think of them as these white togas, but these don't have the purple stripes that would be associated with senators. All right, there's no purple stripes on them. So that's kind of what's wrong with this picture. All right, then we have here a little thing here. Roman fashion and clothing was constantly changing. There was always a new style for Romans to adopt into their daily clothes, much like today's ever-changing fashions. In other words, even Romans would say, oh, girlfriend, that's so second century. Right, so this is changing, especially for women's fashion. Here's some rings. So they had rings. You can still find them. Then they have, here's a signet ring. The signet rings were very important for the Romans, so they would seal their letters with this. And then another important piece of jewelry was a bulla. And the question is, who wore this? We know for sure young men wore this. And it would be a special pouch that would have like charms and stuff in it, and they'd wear it around their neck. Okay? And it was a way to ward off evil. And then once you put on your toga virilis, you took off your toga praetexta, you would dedicate this to the gods. Alright? Here's some Roman clothing for women. And the thing you want to know about Romans, that the Roman clothing for women is more varied. But they had a standard clothing that they'd wear. They'd have a stola, which was the dress underneath the toga. Sometimes they would have several layers. So you look here, the stola would be this here. And then there's another clothing they'd have on top. So you have a stola, and then on top of the stola, you'd have kind of a shawl type thing that you would wrap over it called a palla. And that's what's in her hand. It's kind of a female style toga. Palla over the stola. See the stola on this statue right here, and then the palla is wrapped around. So that's typical female. She's covered her head as well. And then there was Greek clothing taken over, Greek style clothing taken over from the Greeks. So there's the peplos. I'd be writing these down. You can always go back in the video. The peplos, which would be attached to the brooches would attach it to the top, and then you have a belt to tie it close to the body. A chiton, which would be, you put it on, and then it would be fastened above your arms, like that. And then you could tie it cinch it with a belt. Also, hairstyles, of course, changed, and often hairstyles would change. Romans would try to convey coolness. You can tell this is Pompey here on the left, and Pompey always wanted to be like Alexander the Great, and his hairstyle is actually done like many of the statues of Alexander the Great. Here, this is Hadrian, I believe, and you can see that he is wearing a beard that's signifying that he wants to be a philosopher, because a philosopher is wore a beard, so it's trying to show how thoughtful he is, whereas Pompey's trying to show his conquering swagger. All right, and of course, then women's hairstyles changed an awful lot. Here's the picture. And then they got ornate. It shows status, to be able to have the time to do your hair like this and not have to go out and work. Here's a really beautiful one from the first century. Look at those ringlets. Boy, that would take a long time to put together. Here's some more jewelry. And here's another woman's hairstyle. So the women's hairstyle would change a lot. This is kind of how women's hairstyles changed a lot today. And there we go. All right, if you have questions, please talk to me in class. Make sure to write down the stuff about the togas. And valete omnes lingua latina est vita.